The head of the International Atomic Energy Agency, the IAEA, called Monday for an end to the war in Ukraine, warning Europe's largest nuclear power plant remains under fire. Speaking to delegates at the UN agency's annual conference in Austria, Rafael Grossi said this war must stop, as he detailed the difficulties currently facing the world and the IAEA's most personal commitment to mitigate against those challenges. Grossi said preventing a nuclear accident at the Zaporizhia nuclear power plant in eastern Ukraine needs to be a top priority. He said he's ready to restart talks with both Ukraine and Russia on establishing a security zone around the plant.
Last week, I had an opportunity to start consultations with Ukraine and with the Russian Federation on the urgent establishment of a nuclear safety and security protection zone around the Zaporizhia nuclear power plant. This is possible. This must be done. And I am ready to continue these consultations in both countries this week so that we can protect this plant.
Grossi said everything that can be done must be done to prevent a nuclear accident at the Zaporizhia plant. He told the conference if something does happen, there will not be a natural catastrophe to blame for it. He said we'll just have our own inaction because we knew what needed to be done. Secretary of State Antony Blinken said Monday the U.S. is committing another $457.5 million in law enforcement and civil security assistance to Ukraine. The top U.S. diplomat said Washington expects the aid, along with $187 million sent to Kyiv earlier, will continue to help Ukraine fend off Russia's seven-month invasion and sends money directly to the National Police of Ukraine. A party with neo-fascist roots has won the most votes in Italy's national election, setting the stage Monday for talks to create the country's first far-right-led government since World War II, with Giorgia Meloni at the helm as Italy's first woman premier. Italy's lurch to the far right immediately shifted Europe's geopolitics, placing the Eurosceptic far-right Brothers of Italy in position to lead a founding member of the European Union and its third largest economy. The shift in Italy follows a similar right-wing victory in Sweden and recent gains by the far right in France and Spain. Right-wing leaders across Europe immediately hailed the 45-year-old Meloni's victory as sending an historic nationalist message to the European Union, while Italy's left warned of dark days ahead and vowed to keep Italy in the heart of Europe. Near final results Monday showed the center-right coalition netting 44% of the parliamentary vote, with Meloni's Brothers of Italy snatching 26% in its biggest win in a decade-long meteoric rise. South African protesters, angry over water shortages Monday, shut down part of the country's longest highway with rock barricades and burning tires. Vicky Stark reports for VOA from Cape Town, South Africa.
Police describe the situation in Ventersburg in the Free State province as volatile. The rural town is a popular refueling and resting place for motorists and truckers traveling on the N1 highway, which stretches from Cape Town in the south to the Bight Bridge border post with Zimbabwe in the north. Warrant Officer Lorraine Earle says the Valcom Public Order Policing Unit is on the ground monitoring the situation. She says they have spoken to some of the protesters and asked about their demands.
They started this morning to protest. Because of the water situation in town, it's now for the past few weeks that they don't have water. Members are on the scene. They are monitoring the situation. And nobody was arrested as yet.
She says they have had water problems in Ventersburg on and off for the past 7 weeks, with no water for the past 3 weeks. Vicky Stark for VOA News, Cape Town, South Africa.
The U.S. space agency NASA is preparing to test its asteroid-deflecting DART spacecraft as the vehicle, launched 10 months ago, is expected to impact an asteroid Monday. It's the test of the world's first planetary defense system designed to prevent a doomsday collision with Earth. The cube-shaped impactor spacecraft is roughly the size of a vending machine, and NASA says it is on course to fly into an asteroid called Dimorphos, which is about as large as a football stadium. Repeating the hour's top news story, the head of the International Atomic Energy Agency called Monday for an end to the war in Ukraine.
Hi, thank you for watching. I hope the videos are useful for you. Please subscribe to my channel using the button below.